Now there are various form of custodial death. You can die because of old age, you can die because of disease. When you are in the prison, somebody from the opposite gang can come and kill you. So these are all custodial death. But there has been 1731 death that has happened because of the violence or the torture of the police officer. And do you know how many arrests has been made? Zero. There has been zero arrest or zero police who have been convicted of murdering a person whom they have arrested. And if you see the numbers in Tamil Nadu, the numbers has been increasing year by year. There has been plenty of police violence under the current government. To name the few, the first one would come to my mind is the Jallikattu. The Jallikattu protest, a peaceful protest was going on everywhere. And day by day, the media coverage, the protest was expanding. And the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu was under tremendous pressure to stop the protest. And on the final day of the protest, he ordered his policemen, and police did stop the protest. But how did they stop? They started burning the autos, they started burning buses, they started burning shops, and a huge violence took place on the last day of Jallikattu protest. And many footage that recorded clearly showed that police torching up the autos, the van, the shops, and the violence was instigated by the police officers to stop the Jallikattu protest. A year back, a pregnant lady was traveling in her bike along with her husband. A police caught her and pulled her from the bike. She died in the spot. She was carrying a baby which was also declared dead. And later on, the police officer was suspended. So there was zero action taken against him. And the temporary suspension was just an eyewash to satisfy the public anger. One of the biggest police atrocities, if you have to talk about in Tamil Nadu in recent times, is the Tuticorin massacre. Sterlite plant in Tuticorin has caused a lot of problems to the environment, people and the soil in Tuticorin. And people were there protesting to close down the Sterlite which was running in Tuticorin. And again, this started gaining momentum, and the chief minister, being scared that this might become another Jallikattu kind of protest, ordered his policeman. We do not know whether he ordered, but the policeman shot dead 13 people. It was not an accident. The people were aimed and they were shot dead. 13 people lost their life because the Tamil Nadu police chose to die off protest by shooting them dead. Police atrocities in Tamil Nadu is not new. Under the present government, plenty of police atrocities have taken place. People have lost life. Many have not been reported. In this video, we are going to discuss what happened in Sathankulam. Sathankulam is a small town in the same district of Tuticorin. Jayaraj and Benik, father and a son, were running the shop. Police have asked the shop to be closed by 8 o'clock, but Jayaraj was attending to a customer, and because of that he couldn't close the shop at 8 o'clock, and it was 8:10. For opening a shop for extra 10 minutes, he lost his life along with his son. And it was not a normal death, it was a torture. They were tied upside down, a stick was put inside their back. People say that their clothes was soaked with blood. They had blood marks everywhere in their body. After arresting Jayaraj, police dragged him through the market and took him to the police station. His son Benix came to know about it. He took his lawyer friend and went to the police station, and he was also arrested. And the lawyer was asked to stay outside of the police station, and within that night they were taken to an undisclosed location which was not the police station. Their clothes were taken out of the body, they were hung upside down, and a stick was put inside them. Now we are blaming the police. Police has to be blamed, but isn't the judge also to be blamed? Why did a judge order two of the people to be put in central jail of Koilpatti for just opening the shop for 10 minutes? What kind of law is that? And later on, because of this injustice provided to them by the court, by the police station, they passed away in the Koilpatti jail. And later on, when they died in the Koilpatti jail, the report, it was written they died because of fever and because of heart attack, and this was also accepted and the case was closed. This was a torture you would not inflict even on a terrorist, but these two guys who opened the shop just for 10 minutes extra had to go through that by the policeman of their own state. There are three things that I wanted to talk about. Number one, what was the reason that police tortured them so badly? There should be a reason. Police are again human beings. Why would they torture two innocent people to death, put stick in their back? Nobody would do it for fun. Either you are mentally sick or this could be some kind of revenge. Now talking about Sathankulam, Sathankulam has Nadars and Konars. Nadars are in majority. There are Christian Nadars and Hindu Nadars. And there has always been fight, issues, violence between Konars and Nadars. They have been fighting for ages. Now these police officers, Raghu Ganesh and Balakrishnan, are from Konar caste. So whenever they see a Nadar guy and when they find an opportunity to abuse or to torture them, they have always taken it into their hand and they have abused it. Secondly,
What was the reason to arrest somebody who has opened his shop for 5 minutes extra? There is no law that says that a person has to be arrested because the shop was open for 10 minutes. Police could have done two things. One, they could have sealed the shop, or they could have put a penalty or a fine of 5,000 rupees or 8,000 rupees on the owner, that is Jairaj. That would have been an apt punishment, and that could have also solved the situation. But instead, they arrested it. The arrest itself was illegal.
The third thing that I want to talk about is the role of judge in the death of Benix and Jairaj. I feel that the judge is equally responsible for what happened to Benix and Jairaj. After their arrest, they were tortured badly, and a doctor's report clearly mentioned that the sign of torture has been inflicted on them and it is of grade 3. The judge could have easily given a statement that let these people be treated in the hospital, and later on, once they are fine, we will continue with this case. But instead, the judge ordered their transfer from Satankulambu police station to Kovilpeti police station, where these two people died later on. I see no reason why the judge should be spared. I mean, like, that's your job. Your job is to protect the citizen, to provide justice, and you failed miserably. So I personally feel the death of Benix and Jairaj, the judge is also responsible. He should also be held accountable for why did he give that judgment. Now that the protest has taken place, the Tamil Nadu government has asked case to be transferred to the CBI. The Madras High Court has told that the police station has to be shut down and taken over by the revenue officer. I'm happy that the government is serious about this case. But remember this, when the Tuticorin massacre took place, there was huge protest everywhere in Tamil Nadu because 13 people were shot dead by the police officers. They were aimed and they were shot dead. It was not an accident. The same chief minister had transferred the case to CBI. It has been 2 years. Where are those police officers? They are back to their job. I hope that this case does not get the same treatment the other cases have got. And for that, we need to raise our voice. We need to keep talking about it against the government, against the police, so that Benix and Jairaj and every other people who have been tortured by the police officers in Satankulambu get justice. My name is Vinny Singh, and you're watching Politics and Polity.